Hey friends, Happy New Year! If you're looking for motivation to clean your home after the holidays, this is the video for you. Today I'm sharing some good tunes and a speedy clean with me video so we can all give our homes a little sparkle for a fresh start in 2021. If you're looking for ideas on how to store your Christmas decor, I've got that too. Dani, and I'm here to help you find a better balance between creating a happy home and being a healthy mama. If you need tips on organizing or decluttering your home, or if you'd like to follow my new weight loss journey this year, be sure to hit subscribe, like this video, and leave any questions or suggestions in the comments down below. Let's get to it! This is a bit of a random item on my to-do list, but I had these bananas that were about to go bad, so I either had to freeze them, toss them, or make banana bread, so that's what I did. I filmed this video over a couple days. It took a lot to get it all done because I've got three little kids. They're always running around. We have a very full schedule even though we're home all the time. And I started it off with the banana bread because that was something yummy to distract everyone so I could get some more cleaning done. I actually forgot to film putting it into the oven and taking it out, but I did film when I gave a piece to my daughter and she loved it. Cleaning the kitchen feels like a never-ending task in my house. I always start by emptying the dishwasher because it's always filled with clean dishes, and then the sink's always filled with dirty dishes because I just cannot stay on top of it. I'm trying to get better at it. I'm also planning to film a big kitchen organization video this month, so look out for that in the next couple of weeks. My freezer and refrigerator needed a really good clean out after the holidays. We had a lot of extra food in there, some stuff had expired, and everything was just kind of like shoved in there so I couldn't see exactly what I had. I did film an entire video with me cleaning my fridge and freezer and kind of organizing it and putting things in the right places. I will link that here and in the description box down below so you can check that one out if you are looking for specific fridge and freezer organization. My husband was in the kitchen with me when I was doing this, so I'm talking to him, asking him if he wants to keep some of these items and handing him some things to toss in the trash. We finally took our tree down too. We usually leave it up like way later into January. We just enjoy it, and we took all the ornaments off but had the lights on it still, but we finally put it into the bag and down into our basement. And even though it's an artificial tree, the needles still get all over the floor, so I had to vacuum that up, and then my little helper joined me to help me get those needles off the floor. She's so cute. I love my daughter so much. It is so fun having a girl after having two boys. I just love the differences between them. Like, the boys were just never interested in cleaning up and vacuuming, but my daughter Everly loves to clean right along with me. So this is the next day, and I'm going into my boys' room to undecorate, take down their tree, and decorations from Christmas. Hi, Evie. You pretty girl?
Yeah.
You gonna help me? You know that I'ma keep it cold. With you, I feel like breaking rules. On the edge, looking out with no parachute. You know I'm dreaming about us too.
With us it's all or nothing. Oh, but guess I need more of you. With us it's all or nothing. But guess I need more of you. You say it during night, but in the morning you just leave.
So now I'm wiping down their dressers and they are just going nuts in the background. You will see them. This is like typical life with my boys. They're just crazy.
Oh my goodness. Yay! These kids are crazy.
Here's a question for all the other moms out there. How often do you do your kids' laundry? My boys are 4 and 6 and they go through multiple pairs of clothes a day. I don't really understand how, but they always are going through like different pairs of pants, different shirts, and I just can't keep track because they're just doing it so frequently. So I do their laundry once a week. I should be doing it like every other day. I'm just curious, what do the other moms do? Let me know in the comments. I'm putting back on the Christmas lights that are flannel sheets because that's the only set of flannel sheets that they have for the winter. This way they're nice and cozy all winter long. Here's another question for you. What do you call these? Do you call them stuffed animals, stuffies, loveys? I've heard so many different names. I'm wondering if it's a regional thing. We call them stuffed animals and we have so many. How many of those do you have? Because I've been trying to just take them away little by little, but for now I let each of the boys have 2 on their beds and then we have a big toy box in the playroom filled with them. So they each have a Transformer Build-A-Bear that they love. And then they each have one of these corduroy stuffed animals from Jellycat. Luckily, Everly's room has stayed clean. I will link the video where I undecorated her room in the description box down below. Now I'm undecorating the bathroom. I'm just taking down anything Christmassy, but I'm leaving up the shower curtain that I have. It's kind of like a red and white theme, which I think is fine for like the month of January and probably February. And I'm leaving up the red and white checkered curtain, as well as those little wintry decorations that are on that tiered stand in the corner. And then I emptied the Santa Claus soap dispenser so that I could store it away and not worry about any soap coming out and leaking into the box of decorations after I put it in the basement. Okay, now this is the fun part. I bought new clear bins because all of the ones that I had for Christmas decor have cracked in all of the moves that we've done. This is all of the decor that I have to put away. It's crazy how much it turns out to be when you take it all down. I feel like when you put it up, it's like little by little, but then taking it down, it's overwhelming. So that actually sat on my kitchen table for a week at least before I started putting it away. I had to get motivated, to literally just organize it all and put it into these bins. I did not label them this year because I can see right into them, but basically I've got one with the garlands and greenery, one with the pillows, one with any kind of linen like our kitchen towels, oven mitts, Christmas stockings, things like that, another one with breakable ornaments, and another one with our Christmas village. Lastly, I highly recommend getting these ornament organizer bins. They're literally just specifically made for ornaments. They come with the cardboard dividers. I have a large one and then I have two small ones. I've had two of them and then I purchased an extra smaller one, this one right here, this year. And I put all of our breakable ornaments in there and I didn't have to wrap them with bubble wrap because they're sectioned off like that and I'm able to position them and know that they're not going to shift too much because of the way that these boxes are set up and how tightly they pack.
Enjoyed this video and the music and that it motivated you to clean along with me or that it helped you make a plan to start tackling your own space. If it did, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, and if you want more motivation or inspiration to tackle your decluttering or organization, be sure to subscribe and hit the notifications bell so that you don't miss my next video. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye. Say bye.
Bye guys.
Bye guys. False advertising, you were not meant for me, still not surprising.